Hey friends, ZenKahuna here, and it's time to do the longevity ring. Today what we're going to do with it is a brand new move that I created several days ago. So I'm going to take you through the beginning of it. First I want to show you what the no ring version of it looks like, because that's where I got the idea. And I'll also tell you that what I'm about to show you, I got the idea from years and years ago doing yoga and doing an eagle pose. So, here's what we're going to do though. Open the arms up with the thumbs facing back, the palms are facing upward. Then we're going to come in, cross one arm over the other right at the elbows, and push down. Trap your hand with the opposite hand. Alright? So you're here. Now, you're going to push out, and you're going to resist that a little bit. Then keeping that dynamic pressure between the two hands, come out to the front, back in, and then resisting coming up, boom, release the hands, and come out. You do the same thing then on the opposite side, and pull it out, straighten it towards the front, back to the side, resist it coming up. So that's where I got the idea for doing it with a ring. The ring changes the dynamics of it substantially, but it's still working beautifully in that rotator cuff area. Also, all these connections in here, so many people are this way. So what you're going to do is, you've got your ring, you're going to open your arms out to the side and let this ring flip to the outside of your wrist. Turn your palms up and go back. You're going to come in, the hand that holds the ring, that's the arm that goes on top. Then point the ring upward so you can grasp it with the opposite hand. From here, if you've gotten up too high, pull your arms down as far as you can. Then, with some resistance, outward, nice and slow, because we're working the myofascia here. So now, slowly, give those joints and sinews an opportunity to adjust to what we're doing. Back in, resist coming up. Boom. Then you're going to let go of the hand that brought the ring in, and now your ring's in your opposite hand, out to the side, and thumbs are facing back, palms are facing up. Now the hand that has the ring goes on top, cross at the elbow, push down, lift the ring up, grasp with both hands, pull down again, pull it out with resistance, forward, maintaining that pressure, and the pressure coming in. Now, you're going to let go of the hand that brought it in and come out, turn the palms up again. So that would be the nature of the beast back and forth. I'm going to do it back and forth several times and give you a few more cues as we're doing it and a couple of variations that you can do. So, out to the side. Cross over, grasp, pull, out towards the front, back towards the side, resist as you come in, let go. The longevity ring goes to the opposite side. Now, you could go pull down and then resist coming out and then resist coming in. One of the places you're likely to feel this is where your elbows cross, because as you're doing this move, you're going to be stimulating a number of areas that are commonly known to hold trigger points. So sometimes these will be so sensitive you'll have a hard time doing this move. If you just do it a little bit at a time, you begin to diminish and eventually eliminate those hot trigger points. So you see, I've done this multiple times, but I'm also listening to my body, and if it didn't feel like it was time to do any more, or let's say I'd only done two here, now, this is the hand that's on top, that's the one I'm going to let go with, and come back up. Okay, so, there are many ways that we can do this and make it more intense, less intense. I'm going to show it to you from the side, just in your standard version. So, pull, and again, and again. Now, straighten it out more. Keep the elbows well crossed. Now resist coming up for three. And already, this is feeling so much better. This is the hand that's on top. I let it go. Come out to the side. So, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Now there's no magic to one, two, and three. You could do one through six. You could just do one. You can do whatever you like. So if I'm starting out here, there's a little variation I can do from there, and that is just to bring it in. So in other words, if I started from here, out to the front, towards the nose, and back again, is a little bit more range of motion. The other variation would be starting from here, out, forward, towards the nose, and right back out again. So you're getting a little circular energy going here. This also feels very good. So I'm going to show this on the opposite side. Cross, push down. Hold the ring, push down again. Bring it out, forward, in towards the nose, and out. Then, top hand releases, out to the side, and bring it down. So there you have it. If you're new to longevity rings, if you're real tight through here or across the upper shoulders or even up into the neck, you may have some challenge with this. If you've got some problems with wrists or your fingers or your elbows, this is a move that you can eventually do, trust me. But you'll have to start with some of the simpler moves. So watch your other longevity ring videos, pick up those moves, and get to twisting.